Welcome to this spoken tutorial on customization of DSpace homepage on Windows 10. In this tutorial, we will learn to change DSpace logos, modify the DSpace banner, and update the news sections. This tutorial is recorded using Windows 10 64-bit OS, DSpace version 6.3, WordPad and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other text editor or browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed DSpace version 6.3 on your system. Tomcat service should be running. Have administrator authority in DSpace. And have a working internet connection. You should also have familiarity with basic HTML tags. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. The files and commands used in this tutorial are available in a file in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the files before practicing. I have opened the commands file in the WordPad editor on my machine. And I will use the same file to copy-paste the commands during the demonstration. The shortcut to paste on the command prompt is Ctrl and V keys. DSpace is a highly customizable software application. We can customize the DSpace user interface and its behavior as per our preference. The user interface of DSpace can be modified for branding of a repository, communicate vision, mission of the organization, enhance aesthetics and usability, and present tooltip or help to use. Now let us understand the different sections of the DSpace homepage. Open a web browser. In the address bar, type localhost:8080. And press enter. The DSpace interface opens. We have a navigation bar logo located at the top left corner. Below that we have a banner section. The DSpace logo is located next to the banner. Below the banner section, we have a green color bar called breadcrumb bar. Below the breadcrumb bar, we have top news and side news sections. Let us begin with the customization of the DSpace navigation bar logo. These are the properties for the logo. We will replace this default logo with a new one. Make sure that the new logo has the same properties if you are using your own logo. The source code for DSpace is located in the DSpace-6.3-src-release directory. If we wish to customize DSpace, then we have to make changes in this directory. Let us rename the default DSpace navigation bar logo for backup purposes. To do so, browse to the image folder of DSpace as shown. Rename dspace-logo-only.png as dspace-logo-only-old.png as shown. Now let us proceed to copy a new logo into the image directory. For that, open the File Explorer application. Go to the folder where you downloaded the images from the code files link. I have downloaded it in the Downloads folder. I will now browse to the DImages folder. Copy dspace-logo-only.png from DImages to the image folder of DSpace as shown. Next, we have to rebuild DSpace to update these changes. Go to the desktop and locate the file rebuild-dspace. Then right-click on it and select Run as Administrator. If prompted, click on the Yes button in the User Account Control dialog box. On successful completion, Build Successful message will appear on the command prompt. After the rebuild process, the command prompt closes automatically. Now switch to the browser and refresh the page. Observe the change. The old navigation bar logo is replaced with the new one. In case if you can't see the updated logo, kindly clear the cache and refresh the page. Now let us try to add our logo instead of the DSpace logo next to the banner section. These are the properties of the logo. We will replace this default logo with our own logo. Make sure that the new logo has the same properties if you are using your own logo. Let us rename the existing logo for backup purposes. Switch to the Images folder of DSpace. Rename logo.gif as logo-old.gif as shown. Next, copy the new logo.gif image from DImages to the Image folder of DSpace as shown. Now rebuild DSpace to update the changes. Go to the desktop, rebuild DSpace as shown. The build is successful. Now switch to the browser and refresh the page. Observe the change. The DSpace logo next to the banner section is replaced with our own logo. The DSpace banner is used for branding of repositories. So let us proceed to modify the banner content now. So in the File Explorer, browse to the Resources folder of DSpace as shown. Messages.properties is a file which contains user interface text of DSpace. Let us open this file using the WordPad editor. Messages.properties file contains key value pairs. Keys are referenced from JSP files and the corresponding value is rendered in UI. Scroll down and locate the key jsp.layout.header-default.brand.heading. Change its default value to IITB repository. Basic HTML tags such as heading can be used to write the value. If you wish to display the text in a stylish way, we can use those HTML tags also. For example, I can type the value as shown. Now locate the key jsp.layout.header-default.brand.description. Change its default value as shown. Save and close the file. Once again, rebuild DSpace as shown. The build is successful as indicated by the on-screen message. Now switch to the browser and refresh the page. Observe the change. The banner section content is updated now. Top news and side news are used to display updates and news about the repository. We will edit these in the front end itself with the help of the administrator. Click on the Sign On To button at the top right corner. From the drop-down, select My DSpace. Log into DSpace with your administrator's email address and password. For this demonstration, I will log in with my administrator's email ID. My DSpace page appears on the screen. Click on the down arrow at the top right corner next to the admin's mail ID. Then select Administer. we will be redirected to the admin interface. On the top navigation bar, click on the General Settings menu. Then select Edit News from the drop-down. Select Top News in the News Editor section to edit Top News. Click on the Edit button. News Editor page opens for the Top News with default DSpace Top News. You can use HTML tags in the News Editor. I am updating the Top News as shown. Click on the Save button now. Likewise, I will edit the sidebar news as shown here. Click on the Save button. In the top navigation bar, click on the Home menu. The Top News and the Side News sections for DSpace homepage is now updated. Likewise, we can customize our DSpace homepage based on our requirements. Let us now log out from the DSpace interface. With this, we have come to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learnt to change DSpace logos, modify DSpace banner, and update news sections. As an assignment, change navbar logo and DSpace logo with your own logos. Modify the DSpace banner content as well. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by the Ministry of Education, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and the video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thanks for joining.